Hello friends, today's tutorial shows how to use the spike in Microsoft Word. The spike is a copy and paste method that is similar to, but separate from, the Office Clipboard.
While the Office Clipboard lets you cut or copy up to 24 different pieces of content and then paste them individually or all at once, the spike lets you cut or copy many more than 24 pieces of content and then paste that content all at once. However, there is no option to paste the spiked content individually.
I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word for Mac and the recent non-subscription versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for the web or Word for mobile.
To begin, select the text, image, or object, such as a table, figure, or word art, that you want to add to the spike. Then press Ctrl F3 on a PC or Command F3 on a Mac to cut the content to the spike. Before we move on, please note that if you're using a keyboard with alternative or combined function keys, as is found on most laptops, you may need to include the function key to enable the F3 key. This advice also applies to all further references to the F3 key for the remainder of this tutorial. To copy rather than cut, select the content, press Ctrl F3 or Command F3, and then immediately press Ctrl Z on a PC or Command Z on a Mac to undo the cut. The content should remain in your document, but stay on the spike. Repeat these processes until you've added all the content you need to the spike. You can paste the content and empty the spike, or paste the content without emptying the spike. To paste the content and empty the spike, place your cursor in the desired location, and then press Ctrl Shift F3 on a PC or Command Shift F3 on a Mac. All your content should be pasted into the document, and the spike should now be empty. There are two ways to paste content without emptying the spike. This first method is only for PC users. To begin, place your cursor where you want to paste the content, and then select the Insert tab in the ribbon. From there, select Quick Parts in the text group, followed by Auto Text from the drop-down menu. Finally, select Spike from the submenu. Note that if the spike doesn't appear in the submenu, your spike is empty. To use the second method, type the word spike, and then immediately press the F3 key. Alternatively, Mac users and some PC users will be able to type spike, and then press the Enter key instead. You can repeat these steps anywhere you want to paste the content of the spike. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes.
All the steps we just performed are listed on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my complete playlists, How to Use Microsoft Word and How to Use Word for Mac. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a big thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.